So by the way, if you don't know this, quick little lesson on mastery learning. Mastery learning has been around for a long time. Again, we aren't doing anything new, okay? It was popularized and done a lot of research by Benjamin Bloom. You guys know Benjamin Bloom, you education professors. You know Benjamin Bloom, right? Bloom's taxonomy, that guy. But he was a big proponent of mastery learning. Had some research that showed it worked really well in mastery learning. He gets to the end of some specific objectives. If he doesn't master the content, he has to go back and continue to do this. It really fell by the wayside over the years, even though there was great research showing that his contention was that time, if you give a kid enough time and support, they can learn anything. Right now, we have this time-based, you know, basically kids are rewarded today because they can master the content quickly. But what if they needed extra time? They're a little slower learning. We penalize those kids, don't we? I don't think that's a good idea. So, but two huge hurdles were probably mastery learning. When do you actually deliver the content? Well, how do you pick? Because this kid's at this stage, and this kid's behind over here, and this kid's way over here. How do you do that? Well, this was in the 1970s and 1980s. He was trying to do this. The internet wasn't born. This video technology didn't exist. Well, it's not the 70s and the 80s anymore. It's 2011. And there's such a thing as the internet, YouTube and such, right? The other thing that they had an issue is, how do you assess a kid? When do you actually assess a kid? Logistically, it was a nightmare. How many versions of your test, can you have laying around? And, you know, that was such a cumbersome thing. Aaron and I figured out a way to use an LMS, a local learning management system, Moodle, where every time a kid took the test, they got a different test. There were literally thousands and thousands of iterations of the same test. And it really wasn't even the same test. It was different questions, and it's pretty cool. And so we solved that problem with technology. It is, you know, not 1970, 1980, or whatever. So what does a mastery classroom look like? And I'll show you a little video clip of this. This is me. This is me walking around the room while Aaron taught a class. And as you watch this video, I want you to make a couple of notes. What do you see, and also, what don't you see?